click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have talked about the molecular orbital diagram for hydrogen as well as we have talked about the noble gas that is helium molecule. But in that case we have got to know that helium molecule does exist in that is a monoatomic state. So similarly we are going to talk about the molecular orbital diagram for lithium molecule. So let us talk about it. So now we are going to discuss about how can we draw the molecular orbital diagram for the lithium molecule. So let us talk about it. But before talking about the molecular orbital diagram, it is very much essential for us to understand that how can we write the electronic configuration for lithium. Because we know that lithium has an electronic configuration that could be written as, that is, lithium has an atomic weight of 3. So therefore it could be written as, that is, 1s2 and 2s1. So in this case, basically we are obtaining, there are two, orbitals, that is what we get, that is the 1s orbital and the one is 2s orbital. So talking about this thing, then will this both the orbitals will take part in the bonding or what will happen? Let us talk about this in while representing the molecular orbital diagram. So let us discuss with the help of this short diagram that I am going to express. So molecular orbital diagram, it represents the energy level as well as the atomic orbitals, and because of the which the two atomic orbitals, or we could say the two atomic orbitals of two different or two similar atoms, they combine with each other so as to form their respective number of, that is, molecular orbital. So similarly now we are going to talk about, that is, the energy level. So suppose if this is the energy level that we have for the lithium molecule, and the total number of orbitals that are being occupied so as to form the lithium molecule is basically, when we are talking about the atomic orbital of the lithium, this is what we have, and based on that we know that 1s orbital or 1s subshell will have basically lower energy compared to that of the 2s orbital or 2s subshell. So therefore this is the thing that I am going to represent. So suppose if this is what I am representing about the 1s orbital or 1s subshell, and talking about this will have a lower energy compared to that of the 2s orbital. So this is what I have mentioned over here. But we have recently, we have got to know that the 1s orbital consists of basically two electrons. So therefore we represent, usually we represent the orbital with this circle over here, and which consists of basically two electrons. So I am representing over here in this way. So 1 and 2. By talking about the 2s orbital, the s orbital consists of only one orbital that we know. That is, the s subshell consists of one orbital. So we are also mentioning over here as a circle. This represents the orbital that we have did in our previous lecture also. And now let us fulfill the electrons. And we have got to know that 2s subshell consists of only one electron. So therefore I am filling it with one electron. So the manner that I have mentioned over here, the atomic orbital of lithium, similarly, because what we have to do is we have to combine the two lithium molecules as two lithium atoms so as they could form a lithium molecule. So similarly I could say that the other lithium molecule is what I am going to represent over here as the atomic orbital of lithium. Even that will have a particular energy, and the particular energy level will be the same because the both of the lithium ion consist of 1s orbital and the 1s orbital have the same energy. So that's the reason that this will have the same energy. So I am representing over here in this way. And it will also have 2s orbital. So therefore the 2s orbital can be represented in this way. And if you observe that the both the energy levels are the same for 2s or for the 1s. Here it is 1s and here also it is 1s. And it consists of basically one orbital. That is, one S subshell consists of one orbital, and meanwhile the 2s also consists of basically one orbital that I have represented over here. And similarly I could say that I can fulfill the electrons according to the Arbos principle or according to the Hund's rule. So the two electrons can be filled over here, while meanwhile the one electron can be filled over here. So now the main thing is we have to combine this two atomic orbitals of lithium that we have got over here. We have to combine it, and then only we could say that the molecular orbital would have been formed. So talking about the first 1s orbital. So basically 1s subshell or 1s orbital of the lithium, it is very much close to that of the nucleus. So therefore even though if it forms, that is, the molecular orbital diagram like that of an anti-bonding orbital or bonding orbital. So the total number of electrons in that would be basically, if we see, then there will be four electrons, and four electrons in which basically the two electrons will be in the bonding orbital, while the two electrons will be in the antibonding orbital. So if we compare this with the help of the bond order, then it would be zero. So therefore, I could say that there is no kind of influence that takes place with the of 1s orbital so as to form a bond. So therefore, this kind of orbitals are basically known as non-bonding orbitals. So this is what I have represented over here. And now talking about the last one, that is the 2s orbital that is present at the outermost shell. And so the total number of orbitals here is basically 2. So even though by combining, it will create two molecular orbitals. One will be at the bonding orbital, while the other will be at the higher energy, and that will be known as antibonding orbital. So I am representing it with the help of the molecular orbital diagram that is over here, which has a lower energy level, and one which will have a higher energy level. So again, the two orbitals, they will combine with each other, and now they will have their respective that is molecular orbital. So one orbital will be at the lower energy level, while the one orbital will be at upper energy level. So the thing that we have to do is we have to just compare the energies. If you observe, then this was the original that is 2s orbitals energy level, that is this one. But after combining, or after the combination of two atomic orbitals, it has been distributed into two molecular orbitals, and that is also of different energy. That is, one is of lower energy and one is of higher energy. And this is what this section is, what we are going to talk about, that is molecular orbital. This is the molecular orbital for lithium molecule. So now let us fulfill the electrons over here. So the total number of electrons here is basically 2. And we fill the electrons with the help of the Hund's multiplicity rule, or Hund's principle, and according to Ekeeda's principle also. So this is the lower energy that we have. So obviously the electrons will be filling the lower energy, then it will get paired, and then it will move on to the higher energy level. So that is the reason the total number of electrons are 2. So therefore I will fill it over here with 2 electrons. So this is what we have got. And there is no electron that would be on the anti-orbital, antibonding orbital. So this is what we have got, but we have not mentioned the name for the molecular orbital. So the molecular orbital that we should give name to this one is basically, if you could see that this is a 2s orbital, and this is obviously a 2s orbital that we have got, but it forms a sigma bond. So therefore, this one would be known as 2s sigma. While the upper one, or the above molecular orbital diagram, or the above molecular orbital, it will be known as basically 2s sigma star. That represents the antibonding orbital. So this is the diagram that we have brought over here, and this represents the molecular orbital diagram of lithium. But this is not the end, because we have also to mention that what is the electronic configuration of the lithium molecule. So that is very important. So if I observe this one, then this non-bonding that is orbital, molecular orbital, can be also be represented with the help of the electronic configuration. So let me introduce that also. So talking about the lithium molecule, or I could say that electronic configuration of lithium molecule, that is Li2. So if I talk about this one, that is this, since this is a non-bonding electron, and that consists of basically 1s orbital and 1s like this one, if I would represent 1s sigma 2 along with that of 1s sigma star, 2 electrons. And talking about the next one that we have, that is 2s sigma 2, and the next is 2s sigma star. So this is the electronic configuration that we have for that is for lithium. But now let us talk about the bond order. So how can we represent the bond order? So bond order is the one that has a formula of, that is NV minus Na the whole divided by 2. So this is the bond order that we have, and it has formula of Nb minus Na divided by 2, where Nb represents the total number of electrons that are present in the bonding orbital of the molecular orbital, and talking about the Na, that is basically the total number of electrons that are present at antibonding orbital. So this is what we have. But talking about this diagram, so this diagram consists of basically only two molecular orbitals that we are going to observe, and this one is basically 2s sigma and 2s sigma star. So the 2s sigma is basically the which an orbital that has been present at the lower energy, obviously then this is called to be bonding orbital, while the above one will be called as anti-bonding orbital. The total number of electrons in the bonding orbital, as you would see, or in the bonding orbital, as you would see, that it is 2, but that of in anti-bonding orbital it is 0. So we can substitute the formula over here and we can write it as, that is 2 minus 0 divided by 2, it makes to be called as 1. So this is the bond order that we have, and it is basically 1. So what does the bond order gives a detail? The bond order gives a detail about the number of bond that has been present between the two atoms of lithium. So it has been found to be 1. So this is what we have got to know because of the energy level diagram, or we could say like molecular orbital diagram for the lithium molecule. And this is what we have, and that's the reason that lithium forms one bond with that of lithium. So this is what we have got. So in this lecture, basically we have discussed about various things, not only about atomic orbital, as well as molecular orbital, energy level, as well as electronic configuration and bond order. So this is what we have got to do in this lecture. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly and you have got to know various concepts behind this. So I hope you will share this video with the friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.